Hello everyone, and welcome back to YouTube Daily Military Channel, UHAC Brawl, including, the ultra-heavy-lift Amphibious Connector embarks on its first mission to the USS Rushmore off the coast of Marine Corps Training Area Bellows, July 10, during a Marine Corps Advanced Warfighting Experiment. The UHAC is a ship-to-shore connector that uses flotation-like pads to traverse various terrains. During its first mission, the UHAC paddled 2 miles off the coast of MCTAB to the USS Rushmore to load an internally transportable vehicle before returning to land. Also available in high definition. The Marine Corps Warfighting Lab showcases the UHAC during RIMPAC. The Marine Corps Warfighting Lab sponsored an advanced warfighting experiment featuring a half-scale ultra-heavy-lift amphibious connector, UHAC, prototype at the Marine Corps Training Area Bellows, July 11. The UHAC is a track-driven connector that can reach reasonable water speeds and access beach areas that landing craft air cushions, LCAC, and landing craft utilities, LCU, cannot. The UHAC was originally created by Navitec, and the project was funded and carried out by the Office of Naval Research, ONR, It has taken a number of years of development to get to this point, said Dr. Frank Levin, program officer at ONR. This is actually the third demonstration vehicle in this program. There has been a 1/5 scale model, then a 1/4 scale model, and this is a half scale model, so we have been progressing. Every vehicle has incorporated more features and technology to help get us to the full scale. Over the past year, the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab has gotten involved, and they are looking at trying to put this technology in an operational context. They have been coming up with vignettes and scenarios on how the UHAC can be used. The goal of the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab was to assist with the development of the UHAC technology and feature the half-scale model during Rim of the Pacific, RIMPAC, Exercise 2014. Showcasing the UHAC during RIMPAC is a big deal, said Dave George, project officer assigned to the Ground Combat Element branch of the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab. This is a great way to let people know that this new technology is being developed, and this is a great way to show what it can do. Today went quite well. We had much better seas than we anticipated, and we were still able to get onto the well deck of the USS Rushmore. The model consists of 2 tracks that are made out of captured air foam blocks, which give the vehicle the propulsion it needs for land and sea travel. The UHAC is intended to be a heavy lift vehicle. The full-scale UHAC will be able to carry 3 times more than an LCAC and can go over more obstacles, including 10-foot high sea walls. There was generally some degree of apprehension, since it is a new and unfamiliar piece of equipment and how it would operate with the ship, said Commander Thomas Stevens, Commanding Officer Amphibious Dock Landing Ship USS Rushmore, LSD-47. At the same time, there was an excitement about being in a position to assist in the development of something significant like UHAC. I saw that excitement and pride on board Rushmore a great deal today. It was awesome to see them so proud of what it is they do so well day in and day out. I'm very proud of my crew's support to the UHAC endeavor. The UHAC departed Marine Corps Training Area The Bellows and made its way to the amphibious dock landing ship USS Rushmore, LSD-47, where it embarked the ship's well deck. It then picked up and transported an assault vehicle back to shore. Today's successful demonstration of the half-scale UHAC is the culmination of months of research and risk analysis, stated Captain Clint Carroll, Commander, Amphibious Squadron 3. Setting the right conditions in the well deck was critical to the safe execution of this proof of concept. The sailors of Rushmore performed flawlessly, and the data collected during this well deck evaluation provides important information for follow-on studies and design improvements. 22 nations, more than 40 ships and submarines, More than 200 aircraft and 25,000 personnel are participating in RIMPAC exercise from June 26 to August 1 in and around the Hawaiian Islands and Southern California. The world's largest international maritime exercise, RIMPAC provides a unique training opportunity that helps participants foster and sustain the cooperative relationships that are critical to ensuring the safety of sea lanes and security on the world's oceans. RIMPAC 2014 is the 24th exercise in the series that began in 1971. RIMPAC, a U.S. Marine Corps prototype half-scale ultra-heavy-lift amphibious connector, UHAC, created by Navitech Limited and the Office of Naval Research, exits the dock landing ship USS Rushmore, LSD-47, in the Pacific Ocean July 11, 2014. The Marine Corps Warfighting Laboratory sponsored a UHAC demonstration during the at-sea phase of the Rim of the Pacific, RIMPAC, 2014 exercise. RIMPAC is a U.S. Pacific Fleet-hosted biennial multinational maritime exercise designed to foster and sustain international cooperation on the security of the world's oceans. UHAC begins first mission at Advanced Warfighting Experiment. The ultra-heavy-lift amphibious connector makes its way toward the USS Rushmore to pick up heavy logistics gear and ITV to support operations on Marine Corps Training Area Bellows, Hawaii, during the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab's Advanced Warfare Experiment. Marines testing massive combat paddle boat during RIMPAC 2014, the ultra-heavy-lift amphibious connector, UHAC, begins to rotate on the beach, July 9, at Marine Corps Training Area Bellows on Oahu, Hawaii during a Marine Corps Advanced Warfighting Experiment. The AWE is the culmination of a decade of progressive experimentation conducted by the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab, MCWL, where they are testing potential future technologies, solutions, and concepts to future Marine Air Ground Task Force challenges. The AWE is taking part during the Rim of the Pacific, RIMPAC, Exercise 2014. Lieutenant Colonel Don Gordon, the current technology officer at MCWL, said the UHAC is one of those experimental technologies that displays a possible capability of being able to insert Marines in areas where current technology wouldn't be able to insert them based on current systems that are fielded. The UHAC prototype is a ship-to-shore connector and is half the size of the intended machine. Currently, the UHAC travels at 4 knots using a track system with flotation-like pads that propels itself through different terrain. Huge paddle boat makes ship-to-shore connection. The ultra-heavy-lift amphibious connector prepares to enter the well deck of the USS Rushmore to load up heavy equipment during its first mission off the coast of Marine Corps Training Area Bellows, July 11, 2014 during a Marine Corps Advanced Warfighting Experiment. The AWE is the culmination of a decade of progressive experimentation conducted by the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab, MCWL, where they are testing potential future technologies, solutions, and concepts to future Marine Air Ground Task Force challenges. The AWE is taking part during the Rim of the Pacific, RIMPAC, Exercise 2014, the world's largest international maritime exercise. The UHAC prototype is a ship-to-shore connector and is half the size of the intended machine. Currently, the UHAC travels at 4 knots using a track system with flotation-like pads that propels itself through different terrain. For its first mission, the UHAC paddled 2 miles off the coast and loaded up an internally transportable vehicle, ITV, aboard the USS Rushmore before disembarking and headed back to MCTAB to offload the vehicle. Ultra-heavy-lift amphibious connector personnel prepare to offload heavy equipment at Marine Corps Training Area Bellows, July 11, during a Marine Corps Advanced Warfighting Experiment, AWE. The AWE is the culmination of a decade of progressive experimentation conducted by the Marine Corps Warfighting Lab, MCWL, where they are testing potential future technologies, concepts, and solutions to future Marine Air Ground Task Force challenges.